الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله ذي الملك والملكوت، ذي العزة والجبروت، الحمد لله ذي القدرة والنعم، ذي الفضل والكرم، الحمد لله حي قيوم لا ينام، عزيز لا يضام، قهار لا يرام. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما. يقول الباري سبحانه وتعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Oh, you who believe, fear Allah as He should be feared, and die not except on the state of Islam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most merciful, grant us this great gift to die on the state of Islam. Allahumma ameen ya rabbal alameen. Amma ba'd. The believer in his life, in this journey, he's journeying within this ups and down of this dunya, and the dunya, which is the life of this world. The dunya, and Allah call it dunya low, because it's the lowest of the worlds. And the ups and down of this dunya, that someone is trying to make it, to gain the success, to gain what we call al-falah. And here, the believer, he has always to ask questions to help him define the element of his journey, to define the means to get to this success. And one of the most important things that is really that we live is our environment, is our life, which is this dunya, the life of this world. How the Prophet ﷺ dealt with it. And we would like to understand some of the deep meaning of the teaching of the Prophet ﷺ. Because in some of the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, we look at the dunya that something so low, disgraced, the life of this world is nothing, but we live in it. In a hadith of the Prophet ﷺ in al-Tirmidhi, narrated by Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, وهو حديث حسن. قال نام النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على حصير فقام وأثر الحصير على جنبه. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took a nap on a very hard mat. When he woke up, the companion, they saw the marks of the mat on his side. Loving the Prophet, caring about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ لَوَ اتَّخَذْنَا لَكَ وِطَاءً. Ya Rasulullah, should not we take for you like a mattress? I'm sorry, not a mattress that you know, the thick mattress. No, it's like something thin, so you lay on it, will not leave marks on your side. The answer of the Prophet ﷺ was shocking. قَالَ مَالِي وَلِلدُّنْيَا. In our terms today, it's like, what business do I have with this worldly life? Ya Rasulullah, they ask you to give you a small mat, a thin mattress, so you not have marks on your side. They didn't ask you to give you gold. They ask you and you say, I don't have any business with the dunya. مالي وللدنيا. What I have to do with this dunya? قال إن مثلي في هذه الدنيا كمثل راكب استظل تحت شجرة ثم راح وتركها. My example in this life of this world is like a traveler who took a rest under the shade of a tree and then he left it and he's gone. That's the meaning of the dunya. But in this understanding, should today we go to our homes and push away your mattress and your bed, you say, this is, we're going to follow the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. We should not stay or sleep on our beds. No, it's not. There's meaning. There's a hidden meaning. There's a deep thing that calls us to reflect. In another hadith narrated by Abi Umama, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam عند البيهقي قال عرض علي ربي بطحاء مكة ذهبا عرض علي ربي بطحاء مكة ذهبا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told me, he presented to me to have the valley or the plain of Mecca, which is by the mountain of by Ghari Thawr, is that around that area is like a very vast place. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala offered for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to turn it to gold, into gold to him. قال لا يا ربي, no. I prefer ya Allah. قال أشبع يوما وأجوع يوما. I want to be satisfied one day and the other day I will be starving. قال فإذا شبعت شكرت وحمدت الله وإذا جعت تضرعت ودعوت إلى الله. When I'm satisfied, I'll be grateful, I'll be thankful, I'll be making hamd to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I'm starving, I'll be begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I'll be in dua, in supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, are we not supposed to make money? Are we not supposed to hasten to gain our living? So there's another meaning. In another hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, narrated by Abi Dharr, he said, كُنْتُ مَعَ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَمْشِي قَالَ فِي حَرَّةِ الْمَدِينَةِ. We were walking in the Harra, the place of the stony part of Medina. قَالَ فَاسْتَقْبَلَنَا أُحُدْ. And subhanAllah, it appeared to them Uhud. And Uhud is a chain of mountain. It's a very large chain of mountain. قَالَ يَا أَبَا ذَرْ قَالَ لَبَّيْكَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Said, يَا أَبَا ذَرْ. He said, I'm at your service, ya Rasulullah. Labbaik. قال يا أبا ذر ما يسرني أن يكون لي مثل هذا أحد, مثل هذا الجبل أحد ذهب يمضي عليه ثلاثة ويبقى لي منه دينار. It will not make me happy. It's actually make me sad. If I will be this chain of mountain into gold, and will have 3 days, and after 3 days, if I have few dollars from it, I will be so sad. It hurt me, ya Abu Dharr. Except, قال إلا شيئا أرصده في دين الله. Except something I will devote it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why 3 days? Because 3 days for the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to distribute all this chain of mountain of gold. قال فأقول فيه في عباد الله هكذا وهكذا وهكذا وهكذا. I will say among the people, the servant of Allah, take here. On the right, on the left, on his back, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And here, when we look at this ahadith, it's like we need to renounce to the dunya. But it's not. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in one of his dua, he said, oh Allah, make our living to be comfortable. Oh Allah, make our living to be content. Oh Allah, to make our living in which is our ma'ash. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam complimented the one who has a lot of money, but he's righteous. قَالَ نِعْمَ الْمَالُ الصَّالِحِ عِنْدَ الرَّجُلُ الصَّالِحِ. Blessed is the money that is salih, that is halal, that is, you know, taken and gained from the righteous way to in the hand of the righteous man. Therefore, what is the meaning here? What is when we think of this hadith? There is something so beautiful. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is teaching us. It's not the dunya that is bad. It's our view to the dunya that becomes, make the dunya bad. It's the life of this world that is ugly. The inness and the ugliness in the way we deal with it. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is teaching us. When they told him, we take your thin mattress, he said, no. I don't have any business to do with the dunya. Because it's like that thick mattress or like light mattress for him is the target of happiness, is to have luxury in this life. The luxury is not a target in the life of the believer. Therefore, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned us and instructed us to the element, the true element of happiness, the true element of joy, the true element of tranquility.
Whatever the dunya will behave with you is like you have a random target. Whatever the target comes, you have to get to the target. And this target is how to please Allah in every time the dunya face you. It face you with starvation, you are in dua to Allah, therefore you will be happy. If it help you, save you, or face you with a lot of contentment and give you a lot of money, you will be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in these three hadith that we mention, he's happy sallallahu alaihi wasallam regardless how the dunya is dealing with him. He's happy when he's starving, he's in dua. When he's starving, he's in tadarra. When he's satisfied and contented, he's in hamd. When he has money, he's given infaq. So the question is not to gain the money. The question is when you have the money, how are you going to do with it? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he loved to give it to the infaq, to give it away. Therefore, that happiness that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam talking about and teaching us is inside us, locked. It is locked. Because to understand this teaching, we need to walk the path to taste the meaning of this. When you are in a state of hamd, if someone, for example, giving you, and you're dreaming, someone is dreaming about a great car, will you better happy in praying to Allah or gaining or driving this car? That's the dunya. The dunya is giving you a car. What you're going to do with it? Where happiness, your happiness is residing? That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this hadith to determine for us that the dunya is not bad. The dunya is like a vessel. The dunya is like a means. The dunya give you condition, give you situation. But those situation, you need to free yourself from the ups and downs to hold yourself with Allah. Whatever is up or down, you are with Allah. Therefore, you are happy. You are joyful. You are in serenity. You are in tranquility. And when you unlock this key of the secret happiness that we have embedded inside us, therefore you defeat the fear, you defeat stinginess, you defeat covetousness, you defeat the fear of the unknown that the shaitan is instilling in you. Why? Because with the one, you are with the one who doesn't change. The event that doesn't change him is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why when Allah created us, the part of our bodies belong to this life world. That's when the shaitan had the chance, the opportunity to get into Adam. قَالَ وَلَقَدْ خَلَقْنَاكُمْ ثُمَّ صَوَّرْنَاكُمْ ثُمَّ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا Adam. Behold, we have created you and we have fashioned you. And then we said to the angel to prostrate to Adam. This creation that we have, that's only the shaitan, Iblis came inside our body looking at this body. Who this guy is going to be? This is going to be my enemy. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was not, and he let Iblis, but when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blew the soul inside Adam, that's the value, that's the soul that resides in ourselves. That what is locked inside it, this key of happiness, if we just know it. That's what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam teaching us, not to disgrace the dunya, not to turn away from the dunya, but to unlock a secret inside us, to know how to deal with the dunya, to make out of the dunya in every opportunity to be with Allah, in every opportunity to feel that joy, in every opportunity to defeat anything that pull you down. That is the true freedom if you unlock that secret inside you. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran as an order, as a command, قَالَ فَبِفَضْلِ اللَّهِ وَبِرَحْمَتِهِ فَبِذَلِكَ فَلْيَفْرَحُ. Say, tell them, ya Muhammad, with the bounty of Allah and with the rahmat of Allah, that they must be rejoicing. Not the thing that accumulating from the dunya. Whatever you accumulate in the dunya is going to go. So the fadl of Allah, as in a hadith of Anas, قَالَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ الْقُرْآنُ وَرَحْمَتُهُ أَنْ جَعَلَكُمْ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْقُرْآنِ. Ya Allah, the bounty of Allah is the Quran, and the mercy of Allah that he made you to be the people of the Quran. And in another hadith, he said the bounty of Allah is the guidance contained the Quran, and the mercy of Allah that he guided you to this guidance. Therefore, is this what makes us happy? If it's not, we have a lot of work to do. Why, subhanAllah, the dunya, it has, the way we deal with the dunya, we make like walls between ourselves and this key that we have inside us, if we trigger it, if we make the breakthrough, wallahi, you will be totally different people. It's about the first step that you do. It's about the first step. One of the Salihin, he said, I've been striving for 20 years. And after 20 years, I found the taste of the meaning of the Salah. Wallahi. Well, the thing is, when we read the books of our Salaf righteous predecessors, some of the people, wallahi, they approached me, we've been studying one of the book of Ibn al-Qayyim. He said, it's not realistic, this book. It's something talking about, you know, people that they don't exist in this world. I told them what is not realistic is our heart. Is full of disease. That's why when you look back to these people, they look like strangers. They didn't have two hearts and they were not ET people. They lived in this earth and they have one heart and they read the same Quran. They read the same Quran. But the thing is, as Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an, قَلَّوْ صَلُحَتْ قُلُوبُنَا وَاللَّهِ, he said, if our heart, they really truly cleanse, we will never get tired from reading the scripture and the words of Allah. Never. And we ask ourselves, this righteous man, it took him 20 years. It seems to us something very long. Ask yourself, how long to take any of our youth or our student or yourself who has a good job, mashallah, to get a good career? How many years of study did you do? Ask yourself, at least 30 years. Ask yourself how long it takes someone to build a house. Ask yourself, if you watch someone, as one of the philosophers said, if you watch someone doing like a coordinated action, is any type of art, in a game or in type of whatever you watch, ask yourself how long it took him to get to that level. If you see yourself walking in a full coherence, ask yourself how long it takes you to be at that level, to be like the same that you walk in. It takes long time. We do it for everything. We do it to good, get good grades. We do it to get better profit, to do it to be successful business, but we don't do it when it comes to the salah. We don't do it when it comes to Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the witness and he give you the proof that you have it. When you travel, many of us, mashallah, when they go to the Umrah or the Hajj, when they come, they are overwhelmed with the joy. Ask yourself, why you don't have it here? Because Allah gave you the bounty to unlock that secret of happiness inside you. But when you come back, it's like the whole world comes to get inside us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Prophet, قَالَ يَا أَيُّهَا الْمُزَّمِّلْ قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ. Or the one who covered, he was shivering, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he saw something abnormal. But we are covered with the dunya. We are covered with the love of the accumulation, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَالَ هُوَ خَيْرٌ مِمَّا تَجْمَعُونَ. And when you look, subhanAllah, according to the criteria of the people of the earth, according to the criteria of happiness and joy, if you look to the life of Noah, of Nuh alayhi salam, truly, if you study, as we're studying the story of Nuh, according to the criteria of the people around us in the society, Nuh has a miserable life, harsh life. He didn't have a happy life. His wife wasn't one of the believers. His son was a disobedient son. And after all that, after 950 years of harsh life, he has to build a boat for 4 years. And then he was going to face one of the gigantic waves known. So it was a lot of distress. But yet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called Nuh the thankful servant. Why? Because Nuh alayhi salam, he unlocked the secret of happiness. The secret of happiness should not be in function of the ups and downs on the dunya, is with Allah who never changed. The secret of happiness, when you come to it, you will be, subhanAllah, in a way that whatever comes to you from the dunya, is bad or good, you find the way to be comfortable with it. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَالَ أَجُوعُ يَوْمًا. If I'm starving, I'm in happiness. I'm with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many of you, when they have difficult times, they will be making qiyam al-layl, standing in the night. One of the people, he's been looking for a job for a long time. And he could not find anything. He went to a sheikh and he said, maybe he's a high, you know, sheikh, he's known, he has a lot of connection. He told him, can you please help me? Look what the sheikh he told him. He told him, subhanAllah, you knock all the doors. You knocked all the doors, doors by doors. So-and-so, you know so-and-so. Can you please tell so-and-so? And you didn't knock the door of Allah. He got ashamed. He told him, what should I do? He told him, you have the last third of the night. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes down to the last heaven and he will ask. Go ask him. Wallahi, this man, he's saying, coming back to the sheikh and tell him this is a true story. He said, when he get into the salat, he forget what his dua, he forget the dua. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unlocked for him because of this difficulty that he has, that secret inside him. He discovered himself. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us discover. That's why when I said you go to Umrah or Hajj, you discover something that you didn't know that you have it. In Ramadan, why the masajid are full? Why we have a lot of tears? Allah, His bounty, He's a luck for you for free, for certain time to make you witness on yourself that you have it. You have that element. You have it inside you. And this man, at the end of the prayer, he was so full of enjoyment, he forget even to make the dua. And actually, he didn't care to make the dua because he find happiness is better than, he said, the rizq is on the hand of Allah. The next day, wallahi, the next day, he took the wrong bus by mistake. And when he's going, he saw like, you know, a sign hiring. He entered, he asked someone, he told him, we're looking for someone, he has this qualification. That's his own qualification. His own qualification, he got hired. This is we're saying, subhanAllah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put you in condition not to hurt you, not to divert you, not to burden you, put you in condition to Allah for you. To Allah for you is something that you have inside you. But how can we get to that? How can we get, when you read the story of Nuh, you know that Nuh, he was the happiest person. You know, Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he left his son and his wife, what people they will say today about Ibrahim? They left them in a valley of no flotation. What people they will say? Say, this man, he has a harsh heart. This man, he's not a good father. But Ibrahim alayhi salam, ashiq al-taklif, the friend of Allah. Ibrahim, he knows if he stayed with his wife and his son, he could not be better to deal with them, to help them than Allah. But Ibrahim, he has one concern. It's not Allah with them, he knows that guaranteed. Ibrahim, what is about his son and his ma, his wife? How to unlock the keys of the goodness for Allah? That's why when he turned and he left them, he make dua when they didn't see. قَالَ وَلَّ عَنْ هَاجَرْ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ ثُمَّ دَعَى. And Allah put the dua in the Quran. The unlock of the secret of the goodness. قَالَ رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ. Wallah, I have dwelt of some of my offspring in a valley of no plantation, in the place of your holy and sacred house. What is the secret to unlock it? قَالَ رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ. Oh Allah, make them to establish the prayer. That's the unlock, that's the secret. It's not about Allah. He doesn't have any concern that Allah is going to take care of them. But how then they could take care of themselves to have Allah continue to shower them with the goodness? Three things to not make it long. How to get there? Trust. Insisting and patience. When you pray, you might not feel anything, but Allah told you the sweetness is there. Trust in Allah. You might pray 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, but don't get it to routine. Strive every day, every day. You've been studying every day. All of you, you want to school. You want A plus. You want this every day. Why you don't do it in your salah every day? You ask for something. After today, you forget the dua. Keep doing the dua. Maybe the state of your heart, you have to say that dua a million times. At the 900 times, you stop. You say, Allah is not going to answer me. Allah, that's the shaitan, what he wants from you. He wants you to forget that you made the dua and Allah answered you. He doesn't want you to be happy. How many of us, you leave things, if you remember, wallahi, I ask all of you, please, when you go home and ask, see the gift that you have today. And remember, you make all of them, you make dua for those. But you forget that Allah gave it to you. Why? Because the shaitan doesn't want you to be grateful. Why? Because the shaitan doesn't want that Allah give you more. Because if you're grateful, Allah give you more. If you insist, make the dua every day, every salat, every day. Wallahi, one of the brother, he came, he said, Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gifted us with a son. I said, Alhamdulillah. He told me, you know, Sheikh, I've been doing every day the dua that you ask me. I told him, it's not my dua, it's in the Quran, the dua of Zakaria. He said, oh Allah, give me, you know, from as an offspring. Innaka sami'u dua. He kept doing every day, every day, every day, Allah gave him. But when you go do it 2, 3, 4, 5 times and you stop, because you don't insist, you don't persevere, and that's in the path. It takes 20 years. Alhamdulillah, that's fine. While you're striving, you're being showered with a blessing. Wallahi, if it takes 30 years, let it take even 100 years. If Allah give you the life of 100 years, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to be in the neighborhood of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran, the way of the success, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, oh, you believe, اصبروا وصابروا ورابطوا واتقوا الله. When every action, have patience and vie in perseverance and help each other, have patience and fear Allah and have piety to nourish that patience, that is the way of success. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us success. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى أما بعد. In this way of the teaching of the Prophet ﷺ, unlocking the true secret of happiness, if we can call it this way, we cover it ourselves by the fear, we cover it ourselves by letting the shaitan to define for us the view and the perspective of this life the way he wants and the way that everyone else is following. If you stop a moment and say, that's not right. Whatever money I have, the Prophet ﷺ said, the gold, mountain of gold is not going to help you. Wallahi is not going to help you. If you have a mountain of gold and you cannot even eat, it's not going to help you. When someone came, just give me a few minutes, just share with you the story of one of the greatest Khalifa. One of the Khulafa, Rashid, Harun Rashid, he said to someone, give me a reminder, one of the scholars. He told him, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen. He said, how much do you give if you cannot eat a bite? He was thinking, I said, I will give half of my kingdom. Oh, half of my half. You cannot even eat. He told him, after he answered, he told him, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, how much do you give if you eat a bite and you cannot get it out? He said, I'll give all my kingdom. He said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, your kingdom is between two things. Will be between eating bite and get it out. That's all the money. That's the life of this dunya. That's why when you unlock the true happiness, when you are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing will shake you. Everything comes, قُلْ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ لَا يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. That's why Ali radiallahu ta'ala, when we come to this, if Allah gift us with this situation, we'll live the true life. Wallahi, we'll live the meaning of the true life. We taste the true life. You taste the salah. That tear will make you forbidden to be on hellfire. Truly. You will live different life. Wallahi, those of you who went to Mecca, those of you who've been in the night of power, Laylatul Qadr, they felt something strong. That's what will be your life. That will be your life. That's the sweetness of the iman. That is. And then nothing happened to you. It's like something normal. You're traveling to Allah. That's why Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he was wearing a very thin armor, going to the battle, and he sighed his son al-Hassan radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. He told him, Dad, ya abati, qala ala labista lamatan. تقيك من بطش الأعداء. Why you didn't have something stronger, thicker to protect you? Look what he said. قال يا بني إن أباك لا يبالي. He doesn't care. أسقط عليه الموت أم يسقط على الموت فلا يبالي. Your father doesn't even care. Death will fall on him or him he fall on death is equal. Why? Because they are free. اللهم امنح لنا هذه الحرية يا رب العالمين وخلص قلوبنا من درن الدنيا يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا ووفقنا لاجتنابه. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم برحمتك اغفر لنا أجمعين. اللهم اغفر لنا جميع ذنوبنا ما علمنا منها وما لم نعلم، دقها وشقها، كبيرها وصغيرها، إنك أنت الرحمن الرحيم الغفور الكريم الحليم. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وأقم الصلاة يرحمكم الله.